Hello everybody, today I want to show you how to make a balloon crown.
It is my video response on a couple questions that I received with regards to previously published instruction balloon crown or old king crown. I'm using 260s balloons, brand name Qualatex. Inflate two balloons leaving about 17 cm flat tails. Always keep in mind that even balloons of the same brand but different colors, fully inflated, may have different size. So to make this sculpture using just two balloons, you will have to inflate balloons leaving about 17 cm flat tails, and the inflated part of the balloon should be about 42 cm long. If the inflated part of the balloon smaller size, then you may have a smaller size crown. Tie nozzles of two balloons together in one knot. The crown will have the top and the bottom row. Both rows we're going to work together at the same time. I'm going to twist all bubbles of the same, about 3 cm size. Let's twist the chain of the first two bubbles. Lock both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third bubble. Now let's twist the chain of the first two bubbles of the bottom row. Lock the free end of the third bubble of the first row with the free end of the second bubble of the bottom row. We have made the first section. This crown will have total of 9 sections. Let's make the second section. We are making all sections of the same size. Each section has 3 bubbles of the top row and 2 bubbles of the bottom row. Now we have to lock ends of the second section in one lock twist. After you complete each section, you have to use the balloon with the longest inflated part to make the top 3 bubbles of the next section. And the shorter balloon we're using to make the bubbles of the bottom part of the section. And then again, after you complete a section, you have to check which balloon has a longer inflated part and use this balloon to make the 3 top bubbles of the next section. Basically, we're alternating balloons as we're making each section. Also, as you may already noticed, when I make bubbles, I don't twist them too much. I twist each bubble no more than a couple times. This way I don't use too much of the flat part of the balloon to make each bubble. Remember, each time we twist bubble, it takes some of the flat part of the balloon. If you twist each bubble too many times, you will have not enough of the flat part of the balloon to complete the sculpture. It is very well known, trick of the trade, I would say. If you never heard about it before, now you can use it to make your balloon sculptures. So when you watch instructional videos where balloon twisters show you how to make the sculpture, at the beginning they usually show how much flat tail left using the fingers or palm or ruler. It is always very approximately estimated size. You have to always use your own judgment estimating the size of inflated part and the flat part. As you're making the sculpture, you can always and have to always make adjustment how much to twist each bubble to make sure that you get it right size to the very end of the sculpture. When a balloon twister gives you approximately estimated size of flat part of the balloon at the beginning of the instruction, it's important and gives you some idea of how much you have to inflate the balloon. However, the most important part is actually the inflated part of the balloon. That's exactly what you're going to use to make the bubbles. Unfortunately, nobody yet come up with a solution how to show you exactly how much inflated part of the balloon should be to make any sculpture. It is always very approximately estimated size. Alright, here we have made 9 sections of the crown. As you may see, I leave no flat tails on both balloons, using entire length of the balloon to make 2 rows of the crown. Now we have to cut off the rest of the balloons. Make sure to secure the ends, tie them between bubbles of the sculpture. I used scissors to make a little hole at the very end of the balloon. This way I can deflate nicely the rest of the balloon and use this part to make the nut. Okay, now we have to tie nozzles of both balloons between bubbles of the last, the ninth section of the crown. I didn't cut any parts of this video, this way you can see how I made this sculpture entirely from the beginning to the end. And that's the reason why it came out a bit longer than I expected. With some practice you would be able to make this sculpture under 5 minutes, 3-5 minutes I would say. Congratulations, we have made old king crown. Alright, remember to fix all bubbles in proper positions. This crown should fit nicely any person with small or medium sized head. I didn't trim off ends of the balloon, so you can see them between bubbles. This crown fits my bald medium sized head. You can even try to stretch it a bit to fit a larger size head. Subscribe to my video channel, leave comments, like the video, share it with your friends. Have fun and happy twisting!